everybody. Now, if you own an ATV and you're looking for a little bit more performance, which a lot of times with these big bore ATVs, I struggle to understand why we need more performance. But there's some options. You know, you could spend several thousand dollars changing the crank, changing the the piston to a high compression piston, changing the valve train, put in bigger valves, do some head work. You can change the exhaust, the intake, and what you end up with is a faster but more temperamental machine that you've probably spent several thousand dollars on. And if you've changed the exhaust system, you've also got something that's considerably louder and less friendly. Now, I have always loved the Suzuki King Quad, and one of the reasons that I like the King Quad is that it has such a smooth power band. Part of that is because it's higher geared than a lot of the other ATVs. The downfall is it makes the throttle not very crisp. Well, I'm here to tell you about something that I've discovered, actually thanks to some of the forums where I'd seen it written up, and it's called the Velocity device. And really, it's by Velocity Devices Incorporated out of Canada, and it's a ECU that you swap out with the stock ECU in your ATV. Now, I've done it to an old Suzuki King Quad 700 right here, and it's as easy as unplugging the stock ECU and plugging in the new one. Now, the Velocity device ECU is a little bit bigger, so that you've got to find some space to put it in there underneath the seat so it fits and the seat still fits down. And on the case of mine, I've got a winch controller in there and a few other things, the remote controller, a lot of that stuff in there, so it was a jam-packed, but it still fit underneath the seat. Now, the beauty with this device is that you can have it programmed right from them with two settings. It has a switch right on the ECU unit for two settings, which can be completely stock and then flip it to setting number two, which is the performance setting. Or you can have it set with a performance setting for a low-grade fuel and a performance setting for higher-grade fuel. Now, in the stock setting, it leaves everything pretty much like it is. In the performance setting, not only does it add a lot of features, but it also disables all the limiters, so that now you don't have a limiter when you're in four-wheel drive or lock or reverse, which, if you know what you're doing, is a better plan. But the bigger news that this ECU does, at least for me, is the power that it adds to the machine. Over 20% more power all the way across the board, and includes a higher rev limit, or a higher rev limit before it limits your RPM, and a fatter power band in the mid-range by 40%. Now, those figures are pretty hard to grasp that you can do with just a module. But 20% across the board is a pretty phenomenal power increase. 40% in the fat power band is unbelievable when you're thinking you're almost doubling the horsepower of a King Quad or whatever ATV you put it on. It's phenomenal. And you can feel it. It's really amazing to me. They say that, you know, the Suzuki and the ATV manufacturers leave a lot of power left in these engines, and they do that by producing a really good engine, but they do that with the ECU unit because it controls so many factors to the performance and power and running of the ATV's engine. So now with this, the biggest things I've found is the crispness of the throttle. It now just comes on real quick. One of the things I've really liked about the Kawasaki V-force, brute force, is the responsive power band. Well, the ECU makes the Suzuki King Quad responsive like that, with a burst of power. Still controllable, but instead of just taking time to wind that power up, it comes on, and you've got it when you need it. Huge difference. Also helps the engine to run cooler, so the fan comes on less often than it did in the stock mode. So all in all, really, if you looked at it without any performance increase, you have a cleaner, better running machine. And when I say cleaner, better running machine, I have not done any back-to-backs now to see if the mileage increased. But I would suspect that I would even, somebody that rides like me would even get better fuel mileage because the engine runs so much better in just a normal riding maneuver. Because it runs cleaner, crisper, and cooler. But the power that's available with just the twist of your wrist, the push of your thumb, is unbelievable. And that alone, to a lot of people, if you're into more performance, or if you're just simply like me, and you want to add, say, 26-inch tall tires, a little more aggressive tire, and you're worried about losing that little bit of power when you're up in the deep snow or something, the Velocity solves all that. If you want more information, I've already put that up, I think, down here somewheres. Check out their website. It's under $500 for Suzuki King Quad. $700, they have other models available, so you can see if they have one for your machine. It's unbelievable. If you just thought, I'm going to buy this little piece of black plastic with some computer stuff in it or whatever it is, for $475 or $400, depending on the model, you might think, that's a lot of money for that. When you see what this does as compared to what you would have to do to your engine to make it run like this, I wish they made some for a lot of the things that I have here. Pretty phenomenal. Check out their website. I can guarantee you, you are going to be amazed. Even if you're not a high performance, scream down the power line kind of guy, and you ride more like me out on the trails, you're still going to be impressed with the crispness and the control that you have now when you put this modified ECU in. So that's it. Hey, see you next time. Enjoy yourself, and God bless. We'll be right back.